Welcome to Minneapolis. Every day in Minneapolis, interesting things happen. People go to work. People go to school. Some of the greatest sporting events in the world happen here. But this story is about a different kind of game. This game takes place in swamps, forests, lakes, and castles. Today, at the Minneapolis Convention Center, is the Tournament of Champions. The best players from all over the world have come together to determine, once and for all, who is the best. What game are we talking about? We're talking about Candyland!
I want candy!
Oh my gosh, Candyland was invented by this lady. Her name was Eleanor Abbott.
Candyland is so easy to play.
You just pick a card and tells you where to go.
The National Candyland Championship is something everybody wants to win. And it happens every year. You have to qualify and train for years and years and really know those cards. I haven't won it yet, but someday.
A lot of people say that this is a game totally based on random chance. This game is all about risk and skill. I go for the double red because when you get the double red, there's a 74% chance that you're gonna win, and that's true every time. My approach, well, that would be the literal progressive. You know, I realize most of the people who play this game are between the ages of 3 and 5, but that's suggested, you know, and they always take the allegorical approach, and that's where they go wrong. And when I turned 18, the first thing I did was go legally change my name to Grandma Nut. That's with 2 M's and 2 T's. And yeah, it was a little awkward putting it on my driver's license. It's all about Candyland, and it's all about playing the game and winning the game. To win the game.
The 1978 Championships was really what established modern Candyland, I think, because that was when I first won and became a champion. That day was, it was Lolly's 7th birthday, right? Everyone was really, really excited. Woo, yeah, la-di-da. And we're going through, and David and Grandma Nutter are their way behind. And it's me and Lolly. And Lolly is one spot away from winning. And she draws none else but the gingerbread tree, which sends her all the way back to the beginning of the board. Oh, man, I can't believe she didn't see that coming. I mean, what a rookie mistake. So that leaves the opening for me. So I take the chance, I take the risk, draw double purple. Double purple to win the game. That's how champions do it. That's really what sets me apart. Everyone else just isn't as great. They're just subpar. I don't even know why they're playing in this league. Really, it should just be me turning around.
It was the saddest day. My birthday party. I got sent back to the gingerbread tree. I realized I needed to get serious about Candyland, and so I hired a coach.
Cool! That's right, we're ready to train for some Candyland.
Red!
What color is this?
Blue!
Yes!
I'm playing the game serious, but got a little hard when you went colorblind.
What color is this?
Yellow!
No! This is not yellow. Nona, you've been playing this game like you're drinking a glass of water. But this is like drinking out of a fire hose. This is red. How many times do we have to go over this?
And what color is this?
Red!
Yes! I think you're ready.
Okay.
Now have a yellow Gatorade.
How do you get to King Candy in the Candy Castle? You gotta get through the chocolate swamp. Who controls the chocolate swamp? That's right, Gloppy. You ever see this guy? He's made nothing but chocolate and fudgicles and M&M's all over the place. And that's when it hit me. You know how you beat Gloppy? You gotta be Gloppy. That's when I decided. I'm eating nothing but candy from this point forward. I was hooking all kinds of stuff. I was on the Pixies, Skittles, Caramels, whatchamacallits. Got so bad I was spooning fluff right out of the jar. And you know, it's been a long road to recovery, but I think I pretty much got it under control now. For the most part.
Welcome to Minneapolis, the host of this year's Candyland Championship. It's quite chilly out there, but as soon as action starts, it'll be heating up in here. My name is Milton Bradley.
And I'm Belinda Hershey. And we'll be bringing you the coverage of the 2011 World Candyland Championships, a tournament for all the gumdrops. The crowd has made a strong showing for this year's championship.
I'm very excited, Belinda, to see how the cookie crumbles in this year's epic rematch of the 1978 championship. Let's go board side and get caught up with all the action thus far. David Gloppy Legault has been disqualified for possession of powdered sugar candies. Grandma Nut is no longer able to compete due to a severe brain freeze. It has come down to Ryan Lord Licorice Dean and Winona Lolly Brugman for the final showdown. It's neck and neck as Lolly has only one more space to go and it's the defending champ's turn. The pressure is on. He flips over the gingerbread tree and has to go all the way back. It looks like the tables have turned from the 1978 championship game. And now here's Lolly. She does it. She pulls off the win. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a new Candyland champion.
And this concludes our inside look at the game of Candyland and how Lolly overcame all odds to become the champion of champions.